Hello, everybody. This is Carol's Daily Sauce. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to click on the bell so that you, the beautiful person that is watching this video, is able to be up to par with every video and every audio, every podcast that I upload. I do want to tell you guys, I do have a podcast over on the Anchor app. If you cannot find content here, you most definitely can find it on the Anchor app. A lot of times there are different articles and things that I'm discussing on the podcast that I haven't yet discussed on my page or that I probably won't. Please make sure that you subscribe and share this out. This is a requested video. I had someone request that I do a reaction video on Liv's life. Okay. So, this is all about our subscribers. This is all about giving people what it is that they want. I realize that a lot of people don't like the way that I do reactions. I know that some people say my reactions are weird. I don't know what to tell you. You know, maturity allows us to understand that we won't like everything that everybody puts out. Period. Point blank. End of story. Poo. So I wanted to say that. I hope and pray that this is the actual video that the young lady has requested for me to do. She said that Liv's life had come out with a video about her being pregnant. Now, this particular video that I'm doing the reaction on is the one that actually came out last night, 17 hours ago, because I didn't find another one. If in fact this is not the video that you want me to do the reaction on, please go ahead and go into my comment section, or you can contact me at carolsdailysauce@gmail.com. You can always contact me at carolsdailysauce@gmail.com for anything that you want me to do videos on, anything that you want me to do reviews on, because I am here for my subscribers. With that being said, I'd like to go ahead and get into the video. Now, I do want to say somewhat of a disclaimer. I had been off of YouTube for some time because I was ill. A lot of stuff went on. I personally have always pretty much liked Olivia and Gerard together. I was extremely excited. You can look on my channel. There is several videos of Olivia and Gerard. I loved when I first got into watching YouTube. That was my show, Living with the Webs. I just love them. I love their realness. I love the fact that they were in love. I love the fact that they were a young black couple taking care of their children. Fast forward, a lot of things have happened. Fake pregnancies, or I shouldn't say fake pregnancies. I shouldn't say that to Olivia. I apologize. I will say pregnancies that didn't happen. The reason I say fake pregnancies, and the reason I do want to make a claim, I do want to give you guys an understanding of what I'm saying when I'm saying fake pregnancies, is because in the past we have been told that Gerard had got a vasectomy. But we also know that if a man gets a vasectomy, if he doesn't complete the process, a lot of times the vasectomy is not successful. So, with that being said, that's why I say fake pregnancies, because we don't know what happened. What we have to understand is these three mommies, four mommies, all the mommies, they put these things out as they don't want reactors to quote unquote make reaction videos of them. However, what they do is they put this stuff out so that you all can watch it and for reactors to make videos of them. Because what ends up happening is when we make these reaction videos of them, some people have never known them. Some people don't even know who they are. I have had to introduce people to Strong Mommy Chrissy. I have had to introduce people to Liv's Life. Not too many people ask about Jasmine, and I can definitely understand why. She's not one of my favorites either, no pun intended. You like some things and some things you don't. But to make a very long story short, what has happened in the time that I have been away and not feeling well and off of YouTube, Liv and Gerard obviously has separated. I believe there was some situation where Liv was texting another man, and I also, in looking for a pregnancy video, also noticed that someone who is Gerard's side chick says she's pregnant. It's just a lot of stuff, a lot of drama, a lot of stuff. I'm not going back and looking into all that. I don't want to get into all that. I believe that every time they put these videos out, it is an effort to get people to look. It is an effort to get people, you know what? This is their bag. This is their bag. This is their income. So Olivia, I will just say this. Olivia seems to be in a good place. Her children, beautiful, 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 beautiful. Robin, Christian, and cute little Ryan, looking just like Gerard. So why Gerard would decide that he would want a paternity test, they are going to slap him in the face, because them kids don't look nothing like Olivia. And I don't mean that to be rude. They look like their daddy. His genes really, really took over. So, this pregnancy test. Now, I'm kind of confused because, well, Olivia's in Florida right now. She lives in Florida right now. So, from what I heard Olivia say, there was some cheating one time on Gerard in Houston. She hasn't been to Houston, living in Houston for a while. So, I'm assuming there wasn't any cheating going on other than her sexting to someone else. And then Gerard found out about it. But now here comes this baby mama drama that they got going on. This side chick baby mama. Y'all, it's just too much. I don't understand. I don't understand what's going on. So anyway, Olivia is saying that she has a lot of work that she needs to do. She needs to clean up her house. One thing about Olivia, wonderful housekeeper. She keeps her house. She's always cleaning, always, always cleaning. And she appears to be a really good mom. Her kids were in the room and they were on the TV. She said that the state of Florida is not under quarantine as of yet, from what I can understand. So with that being said, I've got to say, the picture that I seen, and I was going to do a video on people not adhering to the shelter in place order. If they don't have a shelter in place in Florida, people don't have to adhere to it. But from what I can understand, the beaches are now closed, because she did mention in this video that the beaches are closed and the parks are closed. So they have what appears to be some areas that are partially quarantined. Okay. But let's talk about the pregnancy test, because that's what this video is about. As I have said on several occasions, she's married. Even though her and Gerard are not together right now. And I think that's very important to say, because it is a right now situation. Olivia and Gerard honestly love each other. As I said in my video the other day, Olivia and Gerard need to get counseling. Okay. Now, in my opinion, and that's all this is, I don't think that if a man has a whole demon, y'all heard me, a whole demon, that's exactly what I said. I think the only person that can help him with a whole demon is the Lord. I don't think the counseling can help. I just don't. That's just my theory. And I did say whole demon. Yes, I am a Christian. But I did say a whole demon, because if you are married, there is absolutely no reason that you should be out and about sleeping and making babies with other women. Now, did Gerard do that? I have no idea. I haven't been up on it. So they need counseling. They need marital counseling. And as I said in that video, that's only if they want to be together. As far as Olivia and another pregnancy test. Now, she was pregnant. She is married. She is married. The difference between Olivia and all the other mommies who keep taking all of these pregnancy tests is that Olivia is married. I have said this in several videos. If a couple is married and they want to have 500 children, they can do that. Now, Chrissy is also married. Strong Mommy Chrissy is also married. but her husband left. Now, Gerada has left. I don't think it's really wise that a young lady would even be married and intercoursing her husband and getting pregnant, because then you have to go through the issue of child support. You've got to go through the issue of paternity tests. You've got to go through the issue of he said, she said. And what I mean when I say he said, she said, he said this is his baby. She said it's his baby. He says it's not. You were cheating. All of that nonsense that is going on. Now, what I don't understand is this. If you took a pregnancy test and the pregnancy test came out to be positive, because the expression that she gave us was that she was surprised and she smiled. So what I want you guys to understand, the way I took that to be, okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to drag them on because this is an element of surprise. Okay. They're waiting on me to come out and say, yep, I'm pregnant again with my fourth baby. Okay. Like I said, I personally don't think that couples that are married, if they're having marital problems, should have children, because contrary to what a lot of people believe and what a lot of women believe is that children can keep a man. A child can't keep a man. One thing I want everybody that is listening to this video to understand is this. In order for a man to be kept, he have to want to be kept. He have to want to be with you. Okay. I'm not telling y'all something that I read on TV. I'm not telling you something that I heard. I'm telling you something that I have experienced. This is not a bashing video, but like I said a couple of months ago, Strong Mommy Chrissy, Liv's life, and my Jazzy life need to take stock up, and we need to buy some stock in the pregnancy tests that they buy, because they keep buying these pregnancy tests and stock market is just going to go up. Okay. We can mess around and be rich with how many pregnancy tests these people take. Just living foolish lives. Liv and Gerard got married. Everybody in the YouTube world knows that they had problems, in the past, and that they're having problems right now. The smart thing would be not to have a baby. The smart thing would be, okay, decide whether or not you really want to be together. Even if he did get a side chick pregnant, okay? If he got his side chick pregnant, and I'm going by what Olivia said on her video or on her thumbnail, if that did happen, what Olivia has to do and Gerard together as a married couple is decide whether or not they are in fact going to get through this. Not worrying about the YouTube world, not worrying about their family, not worrying about what anybody else says, but worrying about what they are going to do for their relationship, what they are going to do for their children. The problem is they have not gotten to the core of their issue. So when they got married, a lot of people thought, including myself, that this was going to fix some things. But I have said several times in my videos, they have to go through marital counseling, because you know what? All of us come into relationships with baggage. They've been together a very long time. They've had some very hurtful things happen to them as a couple. They've done very hurtful things to one another. And until they are able to get over those hurtful things, forgive one another for those hurtful things, and move on with counseling, it's going to continue to cause problems in their marriage. So, what do I think about this pregnancy test? I don't think Olivia's pregnant. I don't think she is pregnant at all. How are you pregnant but you didn't show us? How are you pregnant but you didn't show us? She not pregnant. It's just an element of surprise. It's just, I'm going to do this to drag them on. If you look at it, the end of the video said, lives life journey. Yep, she got us on a journey of wondering whether or not she's pregnant. And I'm willing to bet that a video will come up with maybe her having lost a child or that she wasn't pregnant. So those are my thoughts on that video. Basically, honestly and truly, it was 11 minutes of a waste of time. I think that she needs to be doing other things other than this pregnancy, fake pregnancy business that these moms have going on. YouTube need to ban them from doing that. All right, you guys, if this is not the video, the one who requested this video, if this is not the one that you were talking about, please let me know. Once again, my email is carolsdailysauce@gmail.com. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Share the video out. Do reactions, reviews, and all kinds of other things. Reviews of products and all how-tos and cook with me's, all kinds of things that I do on this channel. I'm a very multi-faceted channel. I do all kinds of things. But continue to be you. God bless you. I hope that you are safe and sound wherever you are. I will continue to pray for you. You all be strengthened and encouraged. But above everything, be you. Be the very best you that you can be, because you cannot be duplicated. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.